about how mistakes can be used towards your advantage. The title, The Value of Your Mistakes. Help me welcome Toastmaster Christian Casillo.
Can I have a show of hands? How many of you guys have made a mistake? Yeah, everyone's hand should be up. The reason why I'm saying this is because in life, most people see mistakes as a negative aspect. So, like if something bad, something looked down upon. But in the contrary, I see it as ways to learn. I've grown myself, and I am today where I am today because of mistakes. I'd like to share my story today because I am the person I am today because of all the mistakes that I've done and every single little aspect that I value. My name is Christian Castilla, and I was born in Lima, Peru, to a family of teachers who taught me to value education and get a career and study hard. There was just one problem, though. I didn't like studying. I didn't really like going to lectures or listening to stuff from professors or teachers. I was on in my own little comfort zone. But that changed, though, when I immigrated to the United States from Peru at the age of 7. Living in Peru for many years, I was in a middle-class family, so I had everything I really needed. But once I moved to the United States, I got exposed to a new low socioeconomic status, and I was around people that didn't want to strive for anything in their life. I knew that because of this reason, my elementary and middle school days weren't the best. I didn't pass my classes. I would often not want to pursue anything in my life. But as seeing all my peers get arrested or experiencing bad stuff, I knew I wanted to escape this world. One day, one of my teachers told me, "Christian, find something you're good at and stick to it. Maybe you can get something out of it." And so I listened, and I thought of a good idea. Maybe I should pay attention to class today. So when I started paying attention in math specifically, I realized I had a gift. I didn't know I was good at math, and I ended up doing way much better than a lot of the students around my class, to the point that I started getting better grades than the higher grade students. I'm proud of this because when I was a freshman in college, I started in Algebra 1A, the lowest class anybody can be in. But then I excelled myself all the way into passing the AP Calculus exam.
Oh,
I graduated high school.
Nice.
Yeah.
Every time I noticed I did math, I always made a mistake every time I did a problem. But the more mistakes I did, the more I became perfect at it. So I started picturing my mentality in life towards this method. And so my grades started improving drastically. And I was the first person in my family to get accepted to college. I was really proud of this moment. And I transitioned to college with such a hunger to succeed. But it was really different. College was way much harder, and I didn't think I was going to be able to do it. One of them, classes were much harder. Scheduling was really hard. And teachers didn't know how to teach. I knew that I'll have to do something, otherwise I was not going to be able to pass college as well. My freshman year suffered, and I didn't make many mistakes because I wanted to stay in my comfort zone and avoid things that I feared the most, such as exams or stuff that stressed me out. I wanted to change, and so I did. One example that I like to view is, that's a roller coaster. How many of you guys are like roller coasters? Okay. I hated roller coasters. I would always be the one waiting outside of the line, holding my friend's stuff, and just waiting until they all had all the fun, and just not getting anything out of it. But I decided maybe I should just go for it and not be scared of it anymore. So when I went to a roller coaster, I decided to go to the biggest and baddest roller coaster of all, the Dueling Dragons.
Oh, nice. Yes.
Scariest moment of my life. well because I felt that I had achieved something. And once I got out of it, I felt like I wanted to do it again. And so this trend continued. And I just started loving roller coaster. I started applying this kind of mentality for everything else in my life. And so I did way much better in my sophomore, junior, and senior year, to the point that I was the first one in my family to get a degree. Two firsts in my family, very elated of that. Yeah! So now, I want to be the first person in my family to get accepted to medical school. And I'm currently working on that, and it's looking good as well. I like to say that in life, there is no such thing as losing. You either win or you learn. Because every single mistake that you do is just a building process for you to become more of a better person that you already are.